See, we are not the body, we are a gross mind. The mind is the subtle body and body is the gross mind. Please understand this. The mind is the subtle body and the body is a thicker mind. You cannot separate them. That's why I insist that you all work on your hip joint, your chest. Why am I saying breathe into your lungs? It stays. This is how genetic transfer of diseases happen. Hereditary is because of karmic balance. Heredity is karmic balance. Hereditary is not just some amino acids coming together and forming a DNA. It's not random. It is like this. If you want to construct a building, first you will have a blueprint. Right? You know what is a blueprint? A diagram. An architect's diagram. The building, the physical structure of the building will be constructed only on the basis of the architect's diagram of the building. If the architect's diagram, if the architect has drawn a big hole in one of the wall, the construction workers will not ask, what is this hole? They just follow. They think that it is some design. They will make a hole. When the building is made, the building will have a big hole in the middle. Nobody would know why. Who made the blueprint? The architect of your blueprint is your karmic balance. That's why when I say that we are so together here in unconditional way, it is huge. When you all are working on your issues, crying, feeling desperate to get out of these limitations, it is all solving the karmic equation somewhere. Have you seen the movie Matrix? It's just like that. We are all nothing but equations of karma. We are solving each other. Absolutely. That's why getting a birth in a good home with good parentage, where everywhere everything is taken care of, is so important. Like when Caro was saying the other day that she had some trouble and her mother said, I would help you. What is this? That means the divine has taken care of that side. The divine said, okay, Karo, you have this mother, she will take care of this side. You just go and do what you have to. Right? So somewhere Karo's mother, that soul in form of Karo's mother, is helping her out to burn her own karmas. Probably she feels some repentance. Probably she wants to pay back in her own way. And that is so beautiful. She wants to support her in her own way. What does she have? She has little money. So she says, okay, I will help you. Now Karo has come here. Karo has understood the whole dynamic. So Karo will go back. Karo will try to sort it out with her mother. Once she sorts that out with her mother, wow, both of them are free. So what happened? Karo's mother gave her money to come here. Karo came here, she understood this whole dynamics. She goes back, puts it in action, and both Karo and her mother are free. If you want to look from karmic point of view, it's like that. Like when I see my father, and sorry I'm giving my father's example again and again, because he has been my latest, greatest case study. Now when I see my father had absolutely no mental sorrow. He told us 10-12 days before he died that he has nothing more, no more desires left. He has seen all his near and dear ones. He told us not to feel sad that he is leaving, and he just stayed. But in the physical body, he suffered so much. So much he was suffering in his physical body. What is that? He was burning karmas. Mentally, nothing happened to him. Physically, he used to say, oh my God, this body. My mind was not disturbed. He never said, what will happen to you, my son? Who will take care of my wife? What will happen to my daughter? Nothing. And if you really look, he has lots to worry about. But that was his Ishwar Pranidhan. That was his faith and trust in the God or whoever, whatever. But physical pain he had to go through. So through the physical pain, he was burning karmas. And that's what I'm telling you all the time. That don't be afraid of this tapas. Tapas means physical. This whole agony, no? Agony is a beautiful word. Agony. The suffering because of limitation. And stay on the path. It's burning a lot of karmas. And if the universe has taken care that you don't have any other sources of sorrow, the real sources of sorrow, like you are on the streets or something like very bad, basic necessities are also not met, that means you should really focus on your spiritual life. If you have decent set of money, if you have good salary, you don't have splendorous desires or whatever, then quietly be simple and work on your spiritual. Rest all is just time pass. Pass time. You see the importance. We cry, we really cry for things that we should not. Now look at all of us. We have paid money, we have come here, we have generated 3 weeks of holiday for us to come here and experience this program. Right? Honestly, if you look at somebody's life who is working in a Chinese factory for 18 hours a day, or a little boy who is working in a diamond mine in Africa, or a child labor in India, our life is luxurious. What is that person suffering from? How much karmic balance, karmic debt that person is in? That's why we should be thankful. Every morning we wake up, thankful. Those people die in sleep also. Every morning our eyes are open, thank you. Thank you not because of like, okay, one more day. Not like this. Thank you because of, I will make the most of my day. Thank you for giving me an opportunity to work out my karmas. We are all working out our karmas and we all should work out our own karmas. That's why if your life is not messy, don't mess it up, please. If already God has given you a simplified life, don't complicate.